starting off with the skin, I'm using the Vitamin E Oil for Moisturizer. And then I'm using two primers today. First, I'm using the Baby Skin line. This is the Pore Eraser Primer by Maybelline. I'm using this in my T-zone. And then for all over the face, I like to use the Nivea Men Post Shave After Balm. I like to let that sit for about 30 seconds or so, just so it can get like tacky before I go in with my foundation. The foundation I'm going to be using is the L'Oreal Pro Matte Infallible in the color Classic Tan. My all-time favorite foundation, and this kind of reminds me of the same consistency of the Estee Lauder Double Wear, which doesn't budge at all. Like, this is a 24-hour foundation, and if you have a problem with creasing, or if you have a problem with oiliness, this is the foundation for you. I think L'Oreal made one of the best foundations in 2016, and they are definitely killing the game right now. I love their products. Moving on to brows, I'm gonna just brush them out because they're kind of looking a little bit crazy. So I just like to brush them in the direction that I want to fill them in, just so I can see like where I need to fill them in. So I just brush them out. So I'm going to use this dark brown eyeshadow from the Wet n Wild Color Icon palette. I'm just going to take this on a small angle brush, and I'm going to start just lightly filling my brows in. I'm starting from the inner corner on the lower line of the eyebrow, and I'm just going to work my way up. I'm taking LA Girl Pro Concealer in the color Fawn. And I'm just going to clean up underneath the eyebrows just so I can have a sharper, more cleaner brow. I'm going in with another LA Girl Pro Concealer. This one is in the color Warm Honey. I'm just going to conceal underneath my eyes, a little bit on my forehead, and down the bridge of my nose. I'm also going to put some on my chin. And to prevent any creasing, I like to put some in my frown lines. That's a pro tip. If you have any creasing around like your mouth area, make sure to put some concealer. This will prevent a lot of creasing. This won't prevent all of it. You still would have to like touch up, but this will definitely help. Using the same beauty blender, I like to just blend all of that out and kind of just mix it with the foundation. I like to get really close to the inner corners here and take it up on the nose a little bit. To set my highlight, I'm using the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contouring Palette. This one is in the color Caramel Toffee. I'm going to use this like banana powder color, and I'm just going to use this on a brush and dust this underneath my eyes. I don't like to use the sponge method just because I have really dry skin right now, and if I put too much powder on, especially too much of this like yellowish powder, it kind of makes my skin look dry and flaky. So I just like to use the brush, and then I just dust off any excess. I'm also going to put some of this on my eyelids. I'm going in with a smaller brush with the same like yellowish banana powder from the palette. I'm just going to go down the bridge of my nose and kind of let this bake a little bit. To set the rest of my face, I'm just going in with the L'Oreal True Match Powder Foundation. It's in the color N7, and it's a neutral foundation. I like using this one because it gives me a little bit extra coverage, so wherever I have dark marks, I just use this. And I use this on all of my face. I even go back over the places that I set with the yellow banana powder. And I make sure I put enough of this in my frown lines just to kind of set that area really well. I'm going to start off the eyes with this kind of taupey color in the Morphe 350 palette. I'm going to use this as my transition color. So I'm just going to put this right above the crease. I'm going to just build this to the intensity that I want. From the same palette, I'm just going to take this brown here. It's kind of like a soft brown. I'm going to kind of try to transition this into the transition shade. So not directly in the crease, but closer to the crease than the lash shadow. So from the same palette, I'm just going to mix these two browns and I'm going to place this inside of my crease. I definitely want that intensity to be on the outer corners of my eye, so that's where I'm focusing most of the product, and then I'm just going to swipe it in. So I'm going to blend here, swipe in, blend, swipe in. I'm just going to continue doing that. So for the lids, I'm just going to be taking this off-white color here. I am going to be adding another color on top of this, kind of like a greenish army color. So I do want it to show up a little bit better. So I'm just going to add this off-white color on my lids. So the other day I was looking for an army green eyeshadow and I couldn't really find any matte one. So I picked up this palette from Walmart. It's called Emerald Smoke from the brand Maybelline. And this color kind of resembles an army green color, even though it doesn't look like it on camera. And then this one is kind of like an emerald color. So I think I want to mix them. But first, I'm going to try this color on its own. Okay, so those colors weren't working out for me. As you can see, it just wasn't showing up as well as I would like them to. So I pulled out the old 120 color palette. And I'm going to use this dark green eyeshadow right here. This palette is from BH Cosmetics. Not really sure if they still carry it. But yeah, I'm going to use this eyeshadow. It's a dark green eyeshadow. This wasn't really the color I was going for, but this will have to do because I really want the lids to be very bright and very, very like green. Because this color is a little bit too like cartoonish green, I want to just add a little bit of this forest green into the center, or maybe like on the top. So let's see how that goes. And I can definitely tell it gave me a little bit more of a reflex green as opposed to like a flat green color. So I'm gonna add this all over my lids, make sure I build the intensity. Now I'm going in with this beautiful gold eyeliner by Jordana. I found this at a drugstore. I'm going to just use this instead of black. I want to just try something different. So I'm going to do a winged eyeliner with gold eyeliner. I'm going back in the Morphe palette and I'm just going to mix those two brown eyeshadows and I'm going to place this on the lower lash line. I'm using the CoverGirl Queen collection in the color Ebony. This is a bronzer. I like to use this to bronze my face before I go ahead and contour. So I'm going to just use this on a fluffy angle brush. I'm just going to just give my face a little bit more warmth. I just kind of just put this everywhere. To contour, I'm going to be using the Black Radiant Pressed Powder in the color Rich Mahogany. I'm going to take this on a large fan brush. This step just gives me a little bit of definition right there in my cheek area. And it kind of just carves out my cheekbones a little bit. And I only place it like right there. Right there. And I kind of just drag it out. To highlight, I'm just going to use this Sonia Kashuk bronzer in the color Goddess. I kind of like broke it, so it's not in the case. But I'm just going to use this on a highlighter brush. I'm just going to pop this right on the high points of my cheeks, right there, just to give me a little glow. So I added some lashes. These ones are the Demi Wispies by Ardell. And now I'm just going to add some lipstick. I'm going to take the Armani Amore Matte Lip... I can't talk today. I'm going to take the Milani Lip Cream in Amore Matte. This is a very bright, intense red. It's beautiful, it's velvety, and I just love it. I'm going to also line my lips with a brown light lip liner before I do that, because for some reason I just can't color in the line. So I'm gonna line my lips first. So here's the finished result. The only thing I did was add a little bit of highlighter on my brow bones, and I also added some on the inner corners of my eyes, but that is pretty much it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a big thumbs up. I will really appreciate it. And if you also haven't subscribed already, please subscribe to my channel now for more video looks. I'm gonna be doing like very... like different looks. I'm trying to find like different ideas and different things that, you know, the normal YouTuber like wouldn't do. So I hope you guys really enjoyed this look. I hope this was something different and something fresh and exciting for you to see. But yeah, leave any feedbacks or comments down in the comment section below. I would love to talk to you guys. But other than that, I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.